Okay. You friends, YouTubers, and all you viewers out there, I'm making another video in regard to the Mandela Effect. Okay, now a few people have been asking me why I make so many fucking videos about the Mandela Effect lately. Why? Because I'm a victim of the Mandela Effect. That's why. Okay, so you've got to understand that a lot is happening to people and everything like that, and no one knows how it's happening, why it's happening. And it is hard to tell, and sort of no one knows and can tell the exact reason why everything has happened. But the problem is, a lot of it narrows down to CERN, okay? Certain things, certain dates, i.e. the last time I spoke with my eldest daughter was on the 22nd of September, her birthday. All right, yet on the 23rd, CERN kicked over. And bang, my children just vanished. But someone, a friend of mine in the group, we were discussing the history of CERN, that it doesn't look right. Okay, now I remember CERN being established in 1954 to pretty much research nuclear research, right? Hence the the Council for Nuclear Research, right? The European, so Council European. But it's got the exact way of the words. Just read it. It'll tell you. And, Council European pour la Nuclear Research. But CERN is done in the French way. So, hence, it comes out as CERN. Or European Council for Nuclear Research. Okay, it gets a bit confusing because the French is involved. But it comes out as CERN when you do it in the French way. But in my reality, CERN was founded in the 1954 in regard to nuclear research in, i.e. nuclear power. They were also, in my reality, CERN was involved in Los Alamos and creation and different things like that. And some of the scientists from CERN were involved in my reality in Los Alamos. So, yeah, that's pretty much what I knew CERN as. And I knew 1954 was a bell ringer because I knew that's when they were created, because it was news in my world. But we were going through this, right? And then we got up to 1957, the first accelerator. They actually, in this reality, CERN could be responsible for everything that has happened. Right, yes, I still believe God's involved. I still believe the devil could have influenced them to do it. Yes, I believe everything. Okay, and I don't close my mind to anything. Because at the moment, we haven't solved the problem. But the problem is, everything points to CERN. And that is the problem, all right? The Occam's razor, most probably the simplest explanation, is the truth, pretty much. And every time that we look at it and we research it, because we sit in a group, right, we get on the chat room, and those of you that have not found your way into the chat room, you've joined up as a member, or you've just perused our site. Yes, our site is pretty much just chat rooms, forums, comments, and we've got a couple of pages there because it's still under construction. Yes, the site is still under construction. We haven't put all the bling up and all this in regard to different theories and things like that. And we're waiting, and I'm trying to get everybody to write their theories up on what happened so that we can paste them up into the thing. So hence, our site is still under construction. Okay, so you've got to understand that. You come into our site. We do have an active chat room, right? A live chat room. We have an active forum where people put their theories up and out there to what could have happened. Because, yes, we've pretty much all, thanks to a fellow society member, Brad, we've now coined the phrase, we are now Mandelaologists. We pretty much are trying to solve what actually caused this Mandela effect. And, yeah, we've pretty much become scientists in our own right, whether we like it or not. And everybody out there that has been affected by this fucking thing that CERN did, and yes, I'm going to say it, I'm going to swear. Now, guess what, folks? You come into the chat room and you talk to me, because, yes, we even have a voice chat, only between certain hours, because I can't be awake 24 hours a day. And, unfortunately, the voice chat in the chat box is not working, and we're doing it on Skype, but it's got to be done in the hours that I'm awake. So I've set hours. Have a look in the phone support page. You must be a member to see that page. Yes, you're not going to see me fucking swear in there and everything like that because I've got to play Mr. Nice Guy and everything like that. And yeah, I still let out the odd one, but I don't turn around to people and call them fucking nuts and things like that in the chat room because I'm having a sensible conversation with them. Yes, sometimes I don't swear, but when I'm upset and making these videos, yeah, this is where I get to voice my fucking opinion, where I get to say what I want to fucking say, and no one else can say anything fucking about it because you can't tell me to shut up. So, yeah, I swear a fair bit. This is me. I talk and I swear, but I have to be a good boy because some of the people in the chat room are Christians and don't swear. So, yes, if you're talking to me face-to-face, don't expect me to go, fuck this, fuck that, because I won't. I behave myself, right? And why do I swear in the videos? Because I can, okay? Yeah, it's just me. That's how I fucking talk, and you don't like it, tough fucking luck, right? You want to watch my videos, you're going to have to put up with it. Right? So many people say, oh, you got to touch a foul fucking mouth. Yeah, okay, you might think it's a foul fucking mouth, but it's me swearing. Fuck is in the English dictionary, so there you go. It's an everyday fucking word, so learn and lump it. Okay, but in common conversation, yes, I might only slip it in occasionally. So if you're a fan of swearing, you're not going to hear me swear in the chat rooms that much. Okay? But if you want a sensible conversation about what's fucking happened, if you want to help solve this fucking problem, come into the chat room and talk to us, guys. We have a chat room, just a normal chat room where you can voice your theory. But what you must understand when you come into that chat room, because trust me, I monitor it 24 hours a day electronically. It's got this nice little function that pretty much comes in and cuts up and tells me you're swearing, or you're calling someone a crazy or a loon, you'll get banned. The computer does it automatically, so don't try it in the chat rooms. Okay, that's just a warning to you, all you trolls. You come into my chat room, yeah, you're going to get ejected by a computer. It'll make you feel like a real right idiot, won't it? Now, if you want to be sensible and come in and discuss this problem, what has happened to us, what has happened to your loved ones, yeah, come and join us, guys. That's what it's for. I set these chat rooms up for you, and people have donated to it so that you guys can come in and talk about this problem. So you're getting real-life, face-to-face action. You can type, or you can come in the chat room, in the Skype chat room, and have a yarn with us. Yeah, we can take quite a few people at one time, so don't be afraid to join us in the chat room. But I will tell you this. You want to come into the chat room, you must come in, you make an initial contact with me, add me as a contact before I can add you into the chat. You must add me and make me a contact, so you send me a contact request. All right, if you don't send me a contact request, I can't add you in. I'll have to get you to hang up, add me as a friend, and then I can invite you into the chat room. It only takes a couple of minutes, so don't worry. Everybody goes through it the first time, so it doesn't matter. Don't let that stop you ringing us and coming into the chat room. Yes, and I will boot you out of the conversation if you start trolling. And most people that come into the chat room have sensible conversations and they've all got theories, and everybody's story is real. So, and you've got to realize that because everybody comes from a different fucking version, and sort of some of us come from the same version. There's quite a few people out there that have actually come from my world. It's quite a few people that come from Joe Blow's world, quite a few people that come from Jane Doe's world. Everybody has a different story. They have different worlds. CERN has cracked the secret of interdimensional contact, but in the problem they've done it in such a way that they've kidnapped people. Okay, whether or not they have pulled our soul across. We can't work this out. This is what we're trying to solve, right? And I'm asking you to come in and become a Mandelaologist. Sorry about that, Brad. Right, a Mandelaologist. Right, we are researchers, and we have been unwittingly forced to become a researcher. Yes, we are trying to solve the problem. This is why everything points to CERN. Hence, I've got CERN up in the background. Why have I got CERN up in the background? Because so many times when I'm talking to people and say, oh, when do you first notice it? So I come along and I get this. I've been using this all day today. And they say, this date. And I go, yep, Hang on, just give me a second, and I go and do that. And I met someone from this period today. I met someone from that period. But there's a lot of people that come in after this. There's tons and tons and tons of people. Since 2015, most of the people have come across early. The Torred Man came across on one of these events. Right? He's from my world. And we've actually found a residual map of Torred. Yes, folks, there is actually a map of the existence of Torred. I'll get it up for you, guys and girls. So just bear with me for two shakes of a lamb's tail. The map of Torred is on a map. Torred is on a map. So there we go. Okay, that's not a good one. I'll have to preview it. I'll bring it up. Now, some people say, no, that's where Endora should be. But I've never even heard of the country Endora. So the point is, different things, different strokes, different worlds, different people. And, oh, God. Someone's been hacking my computer all day today, folks. You've got to forgive it. It's causing me a few problems, and we're slowly solving the problems. Slowly solving the problems. But eventually we'll solve it. And I've got to shut everything down, folks. So just bear with me, and I'll fix everything up. So somewhere along the line, somewhere is messing with us, and yeah, we'll find them. And that's all we can do. So, no, it's not going to work. I'm not going to call it up. And this is a problem. I'll call it up in the other one then. So, the problem is, folks, is, yeah, it's amazing what people can do. They can be childish and they can decide to hack you. And guess who we think the hacker is? Yeah, I won't say any names. Soot all of a sudden came after I sent that nice little letter to CERN yesterday, or this early hours this morning. I sent him a letter, so you have a look. Yeah, I truly did send this letter out, folks. And I've just got to close all that. So now try it again, see if we can get it to work. But yes, Torred, and those of you in there that can see it, if we can't see it, man, it's not working. And oh, I've just found it. It's opened up on another computer screen for some unknown reason. There we go. All right. So there's Torred, folks. Torred did exist. Torred was a tiny little country in my world. This is what we call residual evidence. Right? There's also residual evidence of people saying they came from the Orion Arm. And yes, I'm saying from the Orion Arm. In their reality, it existed. So pretty much what you've got to do, you've got to turn around and you've got to ask yourself where you come from, what world you come from. And yes, I've got to say what world you came from. Some people come from a different world, a different reality. CERN has not only merged Earth and brought people from Earth, they have kidnapped us, they have brought people across dimensions. And yeah, folks, you want to see that I get a lot of comments? Wow, I do. That's an hour since I did the last one. Yes, and I get the troll ones, and I delete the trolley ones. So pretty much, yeah, so you've got to turn around, you've got to ask yourself, folks, what is going on? Okay, what's going on? So many of us on this fucking planet now that didn't come from this fucking planet. So how are we going to solve the problem? How are we going to work out where the fuck we came from to start with? That's what we got to do. We have to work out where the fuck we came from. Right, so I've got to, sorry about this, folks. I've got to jump in and I've got to find I've got to look at watch lists and different things, and oh shit, that's right, they go into a playlist, don't they? So you've got to turn around and you've got to look at everything that you can, right? You've got to find the solution. So that's what we're trying to do, okay? For those of you out there that haven't learnt anything or haven't worked anything out yet, you've got to turn around and you've got to ask yourself, what's going on? Why is this going on? If you don't ask these questions, right, you're never going to learn, right? So you've got to turn around, you've got to find out what's going on. Hey, what the hell? Why haven't got a history? Okay, that's weird. Okay, again, as I said today, I've been hacked. There was residual evidence, and we've been trying to solve the problem, and I'll see if I can bring it up, because it should still be in here. There it is, Space Ghoul. A residual evidence that actually shows that people, some people came from the Orion arm of the galaxy. I'm not going to play it, but sorry, I'm just going to pause that there, and I'm going to get the link, because I want that link to go into the description when this video is done. So I'll just call that up. So those of you out there, I strongly tell you to watch the Science Channel, Space Ghoul Milky Way. This is a residual evidence of an Earth on the Orion arm. Yet in this reality, guess what? The Orion arm don't exist. Does not exist in this reality, folks. And it truly doesn't exist in this reality. Which is very possible, right? Because as I said, some people come from here, some people come from there. And the whole point is, here's the galaxy as we know it. We are currently here. It's a spur. It's not an arm. Yet in their reality, it shows them being out here. Because if the Orion arm continued, it would continue out in between the Pegasus and in between the Sagittarius, and it would be out here. So they came from out here somewhere. And that residual video here, this is what we call residual evidence, as I said, goes on to say we come from the Orion arm. This is residual evidence, not the Orion spur. There's a big difference between a spur and an arm. The spur is on the means it only comes out so far. Yet this is clearly showing the, I'll see if I can actually find it, where they're pointing to it. And it shows them being on the external part of the galaxy. So that means their world was, I think it goes into where it says that they shows a picture of the thing and it'll point and it come out. And it doesn't show it. No, it shows the different types of galaxies. There, see, there it is there, right? It's pretty much, they're going in. Out there, and the Orion spur came out and was a whole arm in this reality. It was a whole arm. So we're finding residual evidence, i.e. like Taured. Some people said, oh, you don't come from Taured yet. Why did we find, someone found a map and sent it to me, because the thing, and apparently it's also called Andorra. In another reality, it's called Andorra. I've got to go back and find it. So this is what I mean. People are being ripped from different worlds, and hence we're getting different things. And I could have just done that in the other view. So pretty much what you've got to do and what you've got to understand, folks, that these things are really happening to everybody. And it's true. And this is what I mean. Some people say it's a country of Andorra. So it might be called Andorra in this reality, yet some people are saying, no, that's not, we don't have that here. So what is it? It's called dimensional shift. Okay, so some people come from a dimensional, some people have been ripped from a parallel Earth. So all we can do is get out there and research, and it's up to us, because CERN's not certainly going to come out and say, well, we fucked yous. And pretty much that's what they've done to us. They've fucked us over, well and truly up the arse. And they don't give a fuck about us. They're sitting there dancing because to them, it's a big thing because they've made people turn up in another world that come from a different fucking world. They don't give a fuck. And well, guess what, CERN? We're coming after you and we really are going to sue the fuck out of you. And yeah, some people said, yeah, I'm not going to have win the court case if I swear in court. Well, guess what? I'm not dumb enough to swear in a fucking courtroom. This is YouTube. Got nothing to do with a fucking courtroom. So wake up yourselves, you dopey commenters. Sorry, there are some dopey commenters because you're just trolls, number one. Right? But there are some people, even from the Mandela Society, that have said, yeah, I've got to watch me swear. And you've got to understand, I'm not stupid enough to swear in a courtroom. I've been in a courtroom before and won my case. And trust me, I'm good when I stand up and represent myself. And trust me, I've won a very big case once. So you've got to understand that, yes, I know how to handle myself in a courtroom. Yes, we have a legal case in a courtroom. And you've got to realise that. We have been kidnapped. Right? And I mean, we've been fucking kidnapped. And you've got to realise that. We are fucking kidnapped victims. A lot of people out there are suffering post-traumatic stress. And those of you out there that are suffering the stress, look, guys, please understand in the chat rooms, you are protected. And I will protect you at all cost. Okay, I've even set a computer up so that it does protect you when you come into the room when I'm not there. And trust me, any trolley words, yeah, that kicks them out pretty quick. So just understand, you can come in and you can tell your story. No one's going to rip you apart in the chat rooms. If they do, you tell me immediately and I ban their IPs. They can never come back in. So, yeah, I know it's hard for some of you. Some of you are trying to cope with it. You don't have family that can help you and everything like that because either they didn't come through or they don't want to know about it. They're too scared to talk about it. Yes, this is happening globally. So many victims are coming across to family they don't know, husbands and wives they don't know, children they don't know, children are missing, family has died. So you've got to understand, these people aren't going to speak up for one reason. They're too scared because all you idiot trolls out there scare them off. Right? Maybe if you people didn't troll, right? Because they're taking an example of the way you're treating me and my story. Right? So how in the hell are they going to come forward? Okay, if you turn around and say, well, like this. They're not going to come forward, are they? So if you want to hear people from another, like people's story that have been kidnapped from another dimension, from another world, and yes, we are interdimensional travelers. The very fact that we have, some of us have come 80,000 light years. Some of them may have come from the same planet, just a different dimension, because this is the whole purpose of fucking CERN. So all you dopey trolls out here, you need to start growing up and listening. You could be talking to somebody that comes from another world. How long have you fucking dreamed? And don't tell me you haven't fucking dreamed of meeting someone from another dimension. And this is for the travelers that have actually been unwittingly kidnapped. This might help you. Did you ever dream of traveling this far in the space? Did you ever wonder what it was like? Well, yeah, it's happened, okay? I know it's happened. And I know it hurts. Trust me, out of anybody, I know how much it hurts. You've heard my story in my other videos. So those of you that don't know and haven't heard my story, I had three kids ripped from my bosom. It's sort of, in my reality, I had five. In this reality, only two were born. So two children still alive. Yeah, great. Oh, I love them with all my heart and all my soul. But three of them were ripped from my bosom. They weren't born here. They just never came into existence in this reality. They are still alive in another reality. That's why I'm not losing my block. And I hold to that belief that they are still alive on my world, 80,000 kilometers away. Right? And for those of you that don't know where I come from, right? I come from 80,000. Yes, I know all you guys that have heard this story before. I've showed you this picture before. You've got to realize, folks, that some people don't know. Okay? This is where I come from. I come from over here, 80,000 light years. I was born on the Sagittarius arm of our galaxy, right? And then when CERN kicked over, and bang, here. Now, some people ask, why did I have the CERN timeline up? Now, this is where this comes into it, right? This is one theory, okay? And it's only a theory, but everything points back to this. And I'm sorry, right? The very fact, in my reality, this here, where it's saying it happened in 1959, the proton, this didn't start until 1980-something in my reality. My reality, it was a lot further behind. A lot of these particle experiments didn't happen until the 90s and things like that. CERN didn't kick over, yet on the Large Hadron Collider, yes, the same period of time started up. Now, they didn't seem to have the experience of this world. This world had many years of collider experience. Right? This one didn't have as many accidents by the look of it. And they become more advanced in this reality. This has been going since, where is it? What did I say? 1959? 1959, they started the first collider up and synchrotron, right? So they've had experiments in this a lot longer. So their collider is a bit more advanced. Now, I think this is why it caused us to be pulled to this particular Earth. But I do believe that some people from here have been sent away too. Because some people have got just, they all of a sudden they're alive and they're not existing. And yes, I'm not the only one. As I said, your fucking trolls out there didn't hassle me so much. It might actually spur the other people to talk up. So what you've got to realize is you might, if you shut your mouths, and yeah, I'm telling you trolls to shut your mouths, because your comments don't make light of day. At the most, they may sneak through the YouTube fault that YouTube's got, and it might appear on the channel for an hour or so, but guess what? It's still got to come to me for approval, and it gets deleted. So I don't even know why you're fucking bothering. So you've got to understand, right? I'm trying to get the truth out there for people. Yes, I still believe that this could be a new heaven and new earth given us to us by God, right? But then I have to look at the scientific point of view called evidence. And every time I look at that evidence, it goes to point that this here was a more advanced collider because of the experience this CERN had in this reality. Because I know in my reality, they had an accident, a bad one. This, and strange thing is, this CERN had an accident on the same day. Then all of a sudden I'm in this fucking world. To me, it points to CERN. People, strange thing is, we can monitor CERN. We have a way of monitoring CERN because they've got to put out these public pages. The law states it. And the way that thing, and you can look at the evidence for yourself and you can see it. We've got a link on the web page and everything like that where you can actually see what goes on and how they do it, and anybody can monitor CERN's experiments. Anybody. So that's what we do. We research it. We hear of people coming over and different experiences. Strange thing is, we were actually looking at something online today. Online. We're actually looking at it. We moved away from it for a brief, and this happened yesterday too. Moved away from it. Come back and it's different. And these are what we call minor Mandela effects. Minor Mandela effects. The big ones is when it rips people from another galaxy, another universe, another dimension. Right? None of us think we're going home. A lot of us thought we died. Because we're out there feeling our pulse and we can't feel our fucking pulse where it's supposed to be. The pulse now is on the side of the fucking wrist. Our pulse was never on the side of the fucking wrist. So you got to realize, this is freaky to us. And these are all the things we're going to sue CERN for, because some people think we've died. Some people think we're fucking, God's come taking us. But, as I said, you got to look at the scientific fucking evidence. The scientific evidence points to one fucking thing. The Hadron fucking Collider. And that's the fucking problem, right? You've only got to look at their website, look at their experiments, look at all the different things and computing, LHC experiments. You go through and you can run through and look at everything, folks. And there's a lot of information in here, trust me, a lot of information. And you've only got to go through all these different things and you will find all the information. You've got computing, you've got accelerators, and you go through and they've got educators, students and educators. So all this, and they've got dates and times to all this stuff. Yes, they've got fancy little pictures. They make themselves look fucking good. But trust me, what they're doing ain't fucking good. What they're doing is kidnapping fucking people unwittingly. And then you come to the video where we're happy at CERN. Right? Happy at CERN. Right? You've got to fucking, I'll tell you now, if you give to fucking CERN, you're a stupid nut. Fucking hell, these people have fucking changed reality. Do you know that Stephen Hawking warned them that these experiments could blow up the Earth? And there's a great possibility that these experiments really, truly could. Yes, they have built these machines. How do they know that it can't? See, they don't know the true extent of what a Big Bang explosion inside the machine could do. They could actually create a real fucking Big Bang. Hence, they could blow this fucking Earth to pieces. And this is what all you dopey fuckers out there that haven't woken up need to fucking realise. These people with this fucking machine could blow the fucking Earth up. Do you know the CERN Collider? It's nothing more than a huge, gigantic fucking magnet. Do you know that most asteroids and meteors out there are fucking metal? Metal is attracted by magnets. Now, this is enough to even change the magnetic pole, which it's already done, which is now in Alaska. Magnetic pole is now in Alaska. They've even named a town called North Pole in this fucking Earth. Right? Because that's where the North Pole is now in fucking Alaska. Magnetic North Pole is in Alaska. Go into Google Earth and type in magnetic North Pole. You're going to get a fucking shock. You're going to go to Alaska. And the thing is, you've got to realize these people are just people like you. Yeah, they're smart. Yeah, they've been at college most probably as long as fucking me. They've studied different fucking subjects. Yeah, I studied mechanical engineering in my reality. I studied three subjects in mechanical engineering. Unfortunately, my counterpart didn't go all the way like I did, but the whole point of it is, the thing is, you've got to realize that these fucking experiments could kill the Earth. Right? The whole concept of what they're trying to do is actually contact parallel Earths. Okay, let's do this. Let's do a search. CERN. Parallel worlds. Look at all the results. Scientists hope to make. And this is where they've gone public. Breaking news. So you got to realize these people know what the fuck they've done. Shit, that was a CERN page. Right? So, may detect the presence of parallel universes. Well, guess the fuck what, CERN? You fucking will have proved it. You've not only fucking proved it, you've kidnapped us, you stupid bastards. And guess what? We're going to make you pay for it. Right? Your fucking experiments has ripped fucking people from different fucking worlds, right, that are no longer in their own world, right? More dimensions. You've got to fucking realize that what these people have done. And there's many of you out there, I don't care whether you're a dope smoker or a fucking Christian or whatever, you need to fucking wake the fuck up, right? All the dope smokers out there, do you ever think the government may be fucking making it so easy not get caught, right? Seems they only bust the occasional fucking drug dealer. If they really were trying to stop drugs, they'd have every drug dealer in fucking prison. Why? Because half of them are the dealers, right? So you got to fucking realise, folks, that these fucking things are real. These fucking machines could destroy the fucking Earth, and you need to fucking realise that. Right, their main aim. Right, hear this. It is even possible that gravity from our own universe may leak into a parallel universe. Right? Is this good for the other universe of ours? The experiment is sure to inflame the archivist's critics. Well, guess what? I'm one of those fucking critics because I came from one of those fucking worlds. You ripped me from my fucking home and brought me into this fucking ultimate dimension. Ultimate fucking reality, right? And you guys think it's a fucking huge fucking joke. You're out there dancing. We're happy at fucking CERN. Yeah, they've made a video. You've seen it, folks. You put the link up in other fucking videos. And then we look at these different things, like the shape of the fucking pelvis, the shape of the fucking rib cage. There's too many fucking things here that spell fucking disaster for the fucking human race. And I can tell you now that these fucking assholes in fucking CERN, everything fucking points to them. Right? This is their purpose. And this is what the fuck they've done. They haven't just contacted one fucking parallel Earth. They've contacted multiple fucking parallel Earths. There's so many. I get to talk to these poor, stressed out people every fucking day. Right? And I can tell you now, they're stressed out. They are freaked out. Because they don't come from this fucking world. They were ripped from their fucking home world. And CERN doesn't give a fuck. CERN does not give a total screw-ass fuck about it. Right? You've got to turn around. And you've got to realize that we ain't in Kansas anymore, Toto. You're on another fucking planet. Some of you may have come from this fucking planet. But guess what? Your loved ones that we replaced have most probably been taken to our and sent to our fucking Earth. Somehow, this has happened. And it's fucking real, folks, because those of the old Earth look up to the sky and it's not our fucking sky. Start listening to your fucking loved ones, right? Now, I'm just going to tell every Mandela Effect victim out there, if you are a Mandela Effect fucking victim, go and get your husbands and fucking wives. Put them in front of this fucking video, right? And replay the video up until this very fucking instant, right? Okay, family and friends of every fucking Mandela victim. Yes, I swear a lot. Get used to it, right? We come from different fucking planets, right? I come from the Sagittarius arm of the galaxy. I was born there fucking in 1961. I know exactly where I come from because I'm an amateur astronomer. I know what my fucking sky looks like, and it ain't this fucking sky. I know what my local harbour looked like because as a child, I worked on a trawler. I travelled that harbour a couple of thousand fucking times. In this reality, it points to the fucking beach. How, who in that right mind would put a fucking major shipping harbour pointing to a beach with a that crosses the swell that could turn a ship in a fucking heartbeat? Only a fucking fool would do that. I'd say this world didn't have very good maritime fucking historians back in those days that knew how to fucking build a harbour. And they fucking, whatever CERN has done, they've fucking done a good job of fucking over the Earth and fucking up many people because we've been fucking ripped from our homes and placed fucking here. This is fucking wrong. What they have fucking done to everybody is fucking wrong. It's really fucking wrong. They should be fucking raked over the coals in a fucking courtroom, which we're going to do. And you've got to realize that we can't let these people do it. So if you people out there have family that are telling you they have, this is not their world and this is different and strange to them, and this Mandela effect is real, well, guess what? He is not the only one. She is not the only one. There are fucking millions of us all over the fucking globe that are going through the same fucking thing. Your family is not going nuts. They are a Mandela effect person. They have may have been ripped from another fucking dimension. And you fucking people need to wake up and listen to your fucking family. They are still your family, right? Because it may be the soul that was ripped across. We can't work out yet. We haven't solved that. That's one question we haven't worked out. Was it our physical being that was ripped across, or was it just our soul? Was it our inner being that was ripped across the dimensions when CERN had their fucking accident? But I can tell you now, if they're telling you that the sky is wrong, that everything is wrong, listen to them, because it's fucking well true. You're talking to a man and listening to a man that came 80 fucking thousand light years from his home. And trust me, we've got a society of people that have joined the society because none of you bastards will fucking listen to your family. Listen to them. You may even find out and start opening your fucking eyes because you might find out you're being ripped across the fucking galaxy. You may even come from a different version of fucking Earth, from a different fucking version in the fucking Earth, you know, 80,000 light years, 50,000 light years, anywhere in this fucking galaxy. Because it seems like God made a few fucking Earths. Because I'm on a different fucking one right fucking now. The land masses are different. The way the world works is fucking different. And the devil's even managed to get his fucking hand into this world. Maybe God's got made too many and couldn't control them fucking all. And the devil fucking took over this reality. But you've got to realize that your family are not fucking nuts. There are too many of us out there. Millions, if not billions, of us on this new fucking Earth that don't know anything about this earth. I've got to learn all about my counterpart's life so that I can live his life and better it for him in case he ever does come fucking home, and hope that he doesn't fuck my life up, because I've got a funny feeling he's been thrown into my fucking reality. Because you think about it, if all these CERNs have kicked over on their fucking individual planets, they've turned the machine on, they've had the same fucking accident, and as their giant fucking soul magnets, and yeah, I do think it could be the soul that's being ripped across. And I think God foresaw it. I'll give you a new heaven and a new earth, right? I think God foresaw it and put it in the Bible just to protect us and make us keep our sanity. Because that pretty much is most probably the only thing that's helped us cope, that maybe God had done, has helped this happen, or knew that it was going to happen and he told us about it. Yes, I'm an interdimensional traveler. I come from the fucking outer reaches of the Sagittarius arm. Sorry, folks, I'm dry mouth because I've been talking so fucking long. But your family is not fucking nuts, okay? Grow up, wake up, start listening to them, okay? Start looking at your own surroundings. Look where your pulse is. Feel where your heart is. Look at your own eyes. Are your eyes even your own eyes? Because I know my eyes aren't my eyes. That's one of the things that we're now starting to work out. We've all got different eyes. So if you're a Christian out there that hasn't fucking woke up, open the fucking Bible and read it fucking properly. It's changed. Listen to the Mandela Effect videos that tell you the scriptures. It's fucking changed. You need to fucking grow up. I'm a Christian. Yes, I fucking swear. I'm a fucking field worker. Because I go out to pubs and clubs. And when I am out in the pubs and clubs, I haven't gone out for fucking 4 weeks because I've been too fucking freaked out about what's happened to me. Right? But the thing is, I normally go out in the pubs and clubs, drink with my mates and everything, and talk with them and yarn with them. But I don't even know who my fucking mates are any fucking more, because some of them don't know me, some of them know me even better than I fucking did. So all I can do is get out there and fucking make these videos and get across to you guys to help all the other victims. Because yes, we are victims. We are kidnapped fucking victims, and you need to fucking realise your family is going through post-traumatic stress, and help them. Don't put them in the fucking nut house, because I can tell you now, there'll be 10,000 fucking witnesses backing them up in a fucking courtroom. So you've got to fucking wake up and help your fucking family out. Those Christians out there, wake the fuck up and do something about it. What you have got to do is you've got to help them, not fucking harm them. Listen to them and start opening your own fucking eyes. Because we don't know if the whole fucking world's been moved. And sort of, well, CERN, this collider may have not just moved one fucking person, it may have moved the whole fucking galaxy, right? This collider has the ability to wreck the Earth, has the ability to wreck the galaxy. Stephen Hawking and other scientists tried to stop them in this reality, and they tried to stop them in my own reality, right? Because it's fucked. What they have done, they have killed, kidnapped millions and billions, and move them to other planets, other Earths, other dimensions. Yes, they were successful in their experiment. But their fucking experiment has made it and made a lot of fucking victims out there. So you guys out there need to fucking realise that there's a lot of shit going on out there, and you need to wake the fuck up. You really, truly need to wake the fuck up. And I can guarantee you, anybody says their family's thinks they're nothing, going to try and put him in a nut house, I'll stand up in a fucking courtroom behind him, and I'll organise 10,000 fucking witnesses to join him, to help him fucking prove that they're not nuts. Because, and if you think you've got problems and everything like that with your family and everything, let me know. Show them this fucking video. Maybe it might fucking help them grow up. Because they've got to realise that people have been ripped across the fucking galaxy, whether we liked it or fucking not. So many of us had to build a fucking society just to help each other, because you bastards out there won't believe your own fucking family. The world is not right. We don't know exactly how bad the damage is. All we know and can go by. See, a lot of people talk about this logo's being changed and that logo's being changed. Okay, yeah, they're fucking minor things. Yes, I've done a video on it as well. But I can tell you now, the whole fucking human anatomy is different. Some of them say, oh, well, I don't care, really. Yeah, it's not going to hurt me. Well, guess what? It might fucking hurt you. All right, so you got to turn around and wake the fuck up. Stop looking into commercialism. I went to the fucking mall the other day and I watched all these silly bastards wandering around in the mall, more concerned about what the fuck they're going to eat, where they're going to go for dinner, what the fuck they're going to see at the fucking movies, what they're going to do here. They're too fucking commercialized. This is how they're covering it up. Right, the chemtrails are used to cover the sky so you can't see the changes in the sky at fucking night. They're trying to cover up the fact that you now can see stars in the fucking daytime. Since when have old Earth has seen stars in the fucking daytime? Right, so you got to start fucking realizing, folks, that your family is not nuts. This has really fucking happened to them. So grow the fuck up and help them out and do something and understand them and start looking at the changes yourself. Because you think about it. Your true family member may have been, his soul may have been ripped across the fucking galaxy, could be sitting on my fucking planet, wondering what the fuck is going on. So think about that side of it, guys. You've got to realize that this is fucking happening, and guess what? If you've moved and you've been brought across here, I've got some bad news. I don't think we can go home, because the only way we'd have to go home, we'd have to work up and devise a machine that can pretty much do what CERN did. I.e. we'd have to build a collider, and then we'd just be as guilty as fucking CERN. So no, we're not going home, guys. I think we're fucking stuck here. Make the best of your lives. Don't spend your counterparts' money if you've come into a lot of money. All right, grow up and make more fucking money for them just in case they do come home, because hopefully if they've made money here, they've made money in the other fucking reality for you when you go home, if we ever fucking do, which I don't think we're doing. Right, so you've got to turn around, you've got to think about it, right? You're stuck in this life now, and you've got to learn to cope with it, folks. And, yeah, it's tough. Come into the chat room, talk to us. And there's a lot of victims in here, and yes, all I do is ask you to be civil, supportive, and be nice. Come into the voice chat, and you will talk to me. In voice chat, you will get to talk with me. You must be a member to get the details of the Skype phone number. You must be a member to enter the chat room. You must be a member to enter the forum. So, yes, come in, join the society, and become a member of the society. And I don't care if you're an old earther. And if you're a new earther, come in and join us. Please, well, you're welcome. But please just make the conversation civil, serious, and learn about what other worlds are like. Because I can tell you now, I've heard some amazing stories about different planets, what they were like, different cultures, how the human culture in one world is so peaceful, it's beyond a joke. And they've been ripped into a world that's so violent. And yes, this world's almost as violent as mine. I could tell you stories about how violent my fucking world was. Yes, it was a kind of a world, but it was my fucking world. It's where I grew up. It was my fucking home. My family are there. Yes, we were at war, but we were winning. Right? And we were fucking winning And it was bad. And I've got to admit, it was bad. A lot of civilians got killed in the war. But the whole point is, we were winning. It was almost over. And then all of a sudden, I'm fucking ripped over here. I spoke to my daughter, and one day, next thing I know, everything's fucking different. She doesn't exist anymore. She wasn't fucking born. I went months without knowing. I thought my kids just ignored me at fucking Christmas. Right? Like kids fucking do. Then I find out, and yes, to those idiots out there and the trolls that make the usual comment, why didn't I go to the police? Well, guess what? I got police force in the fucking family. I got police force mates. I had them check. How dumb do you think I fucking am? They were the ones that told me to go to birth, death, and marriage just in case a major accident had happened. Right? Because I would have found out about it in the death section. So I did. Then I found out they weren't even fucking born. So, yeah, they weren't born into this reality. I didn't come into the situation where they were born in this fucking reality. My counterpart didn't come into those situations that I was in. He most probably lived a better life than I lived, right? Most probably wasn't a root rat like I was. But my children weren't born here, okay? So you need to understand that, okay? So stop making your stupid fucking comments. I'll just send you that nasty little video that I send all trolls. And yes, it's a nasty video. It's me telling the fuck off, telling you the fuck off. I hate trolls. And yeah, if you're a cyber bully and tried to cyber bully, well, guess the fuck what? I report you to YouTube. And then they take over. Now, the whole point is, you family out there that are out there and not listening to your family, please listen to them. If they're telling you that everything is different and they don't think it is, that this logo's changed, that logo's changed, because guess what? To us, they have. Because we, our heart or our soul has been ripped into this body, whether our physical bodies were ripped over here and changed in an instant, we don't know. But we know our minds, and we know where the fuck we come from. We know our anatomies, we know our skies, and everything is totally different. So there's one last thing to the families out there. For God's sake, your family's not nuts. Your family, your original family member may have been thrown across the galaxy. But don't hate the family member that's been replaced to it. They are still your blood. It's just their soul has been ripped open and changed. You've got the soul of the other person. You might have got someone better. And did you ever think of that? You might have gotten someone that's much better. Some of you here said, yeah, that your loved ones are a bit different. I've had a few New Earthers tell me their old Earth counterparts have come over and everything aren't as good. But I can't say that everybody that came over was good. I don't know. But all I know is they're just as post-traumatic stressed as the rest of us. Yes, I suffer from post-traumatic stress because of this event. But thanks to all the support in the chat rooms and my friends that I've made through the voice chat and everything like that, I've survived. And I'm coping. And I'm learning. And trust me, I'm learning. I'm learning a totally way a new world works. And I'm telling you, all those old earthers out there, learn the road rules. I'm learning America, especially. Some of you blokes have gone from the traffic lights are flipped upside down. Some of the other laws might have changed. You might want to look in, go and get a copy of the road rules and learn them. I've had to do the exact same fucking thing. Trust me, they're different here too for me. Laws may be different. And the Bible tells you to follow the laws of the land. So you Christians out there that have been brought over, learn the new laws of the land. You may need to do it. And if you any old earthers out there, you can do any research and you find stuff, find stories like this one, please let me know. Send them to me. And please send them to me by message on YouTube, only by message. No, don't put them into the comments page because they just wind up in the spam folder. Okay? Put them in the messages. I will get them. Or you can go to the website and submit them on the website through my email address on the website and I will get them. So those of you out there that have been put through this nightmare and everything like that and you're trying to cope, yes, I feel sorry for you. Yes, I'm doing my best to cope myself. And yes, there are many of you out there. And yes, we're all getting together slowly. So please join the society. Come and join the groups. Come and chat with many others like yourself. And have a yarn about what the effect. And now, to those of you that want to know, are you an old earth or new earth? A new earther is someone that's lived here all their life. The world hasn't changed. The sky is 100% the same. They are what we call new earthers because we've come to this new earth. Old earthers, you can come from any different planet. You're an old earther. Whether you're a flat earther, new earther, old earther, you're welcome in our membership. Please join. Come into the chat rooms and talk to everybody. There's room in the chat rooms for you. And if we run out of room, I'll add more chat rooms and make sure that everybody can talk. Because that's what helps you cope. If you are having a hard time, please contact us. Talk to us. And you've got new family out there. And it's called the Mandela Effect Society. So come and join us. And yeah, learn how to cope. It's one of the problems we've all got. We've all got to learn how to cope. And it gets to us every day. Trust me, it gets to every single one of us every day. And that's the thing. I think CERN wants us to get to the stage where we just give up and don't do anything about it. Well, don't do that. Whatever you do, don't give up and don't let them get away with what they've done. They need to pay for what they have done and they should pay for what they have done to us. So those of you out there that are affected, please join the lawsuit. Because we're doing a class action lawsuit against CERN. We're going to sue the fuck out of them. And CERN, if you're listening and watching this video, which you most probably are, watch out. I'm a man that doesn't give up and I don't lose. And trust me, I'll be fighting this case to win. So those of you out there, thanks for listening. And those of you that are new and your family's got you to watch this video, please love them. They are still your family in a way. And your family in the other reality is going to be loving your counterpart that's been ripped from you. So please do the same for this one and help them, love them. Because that's the best thing you can do for them. Just give them love. Because everybody out there is suffering and it hurts. Because we've been ripped from our version of you. Okay? And that's the hardest thing for us. Because we no longer have our version of you there. And that's the one we know. And we've got to learn to love you as well. And I still love all my family, even if they've come from a different world. One of my family has come from a different reality again. Same world, different reality. And this is what it's like. It's the most confusing thing we're coping with. So you guys have got to understand and support your families, okay? And those of you out there that this has happened to, please don't go off at your family every time you try and tell them about it. Just be calm, cool, collected, and do your best. I love you all. I'll see you together. Hold fast to what you have, as God said. May the sword of Michael protect you and the shield of Gabriel protect you at all times. And may the armor of God envelop you. And yes, even if you aren't a Christian, I'm praying for you. Okay? So those of you, I love you all, and I'll see you all later. This is Bluebeard out.